Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm your host, Mrs. M. And if you haven't, make sure you click the link below. That way you can register for my YouTube channel and not miss out on anything you need to scale your cleaning business to six figures and beyond. Pow! So today in this video, I'm going to talk about what you need to do to actually audition your potential cleaning customers. That's right. Do not take any and every contract. Not every contract is a good one. So I hear a lot of people that talk about daycares. Now, I know I started out doing post-construction. The profit margin was huge. And then I started doing daycares. Now, I've spoken quite a bit about daycares on this YouTube channel. But if you are just getting started, I believe a daycare is a great place to start. But do not look at that as a place where you want to continue as you grow your business. This should be a starting place. Why? Because daycares are normally not, they do not require more than one person, which may you may be cleaning by yourself. Doesn't require a lot of special equipment. You don't have to necessarily do the floors within the daycare. And it doesn't require a lot of money for you to get started. And the other thing is the decision maker is normally in the daycare, so it doesn't take a long time for them to decide they want you. But as you grow your business, when you start to get to around, you know, let's say $5,000 a month, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, $9,000, you're getting to six figures. Even before then, you want to audition your potential cleaning customers. It has to be a great fit for you as well. So do not go into that type of situation where the customer feels like they have all the cards. Let them know that you're there to audition them as well. And you don't have to say it that way, but you can ask certain questions like, why are they looking for a company? How often have they had to change companies? What have been the biggest complaints that they've had about new customers when they've gotten new cleaning companies? Look at a pattern. It may sound as if they feel like, you know, it's all about them. Yes, your customers should feel special and they should feel as if you really care about them, but not at the exclusion of you or your cleaning crew. If it's you alone, you do not want to be tired and burnt out. And if you have a crew, you don't want them to be subjected to just anything either. So I say audition your potential cleaning customers just like they're auditioning you. And you want to be selective. As you scale your business towards six figures and beyond, pow, you want to take your time and make sure it's a good fit. You don't want to get an account, get rid of one. But like I said, what you may accept in the beginning may not be what you start to accept as your business grows. If you want to learn more, guess what? You can either give me a call at 407-986-8228, or you can sign up for and register for our free masterclass, which is how to scale your cleaning business to six figures and beyond, pow, within 12 months. That's right. How to scale it and how to look at getting there within 12 months. So if that sounds like something you would really love to learn, then make sure you click the link, register. I look forward to seeing you there. Bring the energy, bring some pencil and paper to write down a pen, paper, whatever you're writing on. Make sure you have it. And also make sure you're ready to implement what you learn. It's not all about just taking notes. It's about implementing. So I'd love to see you there. Make sure you click the link to register for the free masterclass. Exactly what the name of it is. Six Figures and Beyond. Pow! Within 12 months. How to scale your cleaning business to six figures and beyond within 12 months. Look forward to seeing you there. Click to register. And until next time, be safe. Bye-bye.